Hi, Greg.
Hey, Isa.
Hi, everyone. If you're joining us, it's because you want to know about Scholarships 101 at MCPHS. So this session is specifically for international students, and it's specifically about the renewable merit scholarships that we offer. So, Greg, I guess the first question that everyone listening in on this wants to know is, does MCPHS offer scholarships for international students?
Yeah, that's usually one of the first questions that I get, and I'm happy to say at MCPHS University, not only yes, do we offer scholarships for international students, but they're actually the same amount that we offer to our domestic students as well. So as an international applicant, you wouldn't be treated any differently, and you'd be eligible for the full range of scholarships that our domestic students would be eligible for as well. I also do want to take a quick moment just to let everybody know, if you do have questions throughout this presentation at all, please do go ahead and list those out in the chat box. I believe should be a chat button to the bottom right hand side of your screen. So if you do have any questions, feel free to let those write those in the chat box for either of us. But Ita, another question that I usually get that I'm hoping you might be able to help answer for the audience is, are there full scholarships opportunities at all available for international students?
Well, actually, on that question, we're going to have to say no. MCPHS does not offer full tuition scholarships. Scholarship amounts are between $2,000 and $16,000 US dollars per year, renewable every year. So in comparison to tuition, for example, if you watched the Financing Your Education session on this same platform, it told you that undergraduate tuition is about $34,000 a year. The maximum scholarship of $16,000 that we offer to students would cover about half of your tuition. Greg, do all programs offer scholarships?
Another good question that we get all the time. So for first year students, anybody who is coming into an undergraduate program, yes, every single program does have the ability for you to qualify for scholarships. The only exception would be for some of our graduate level programs. So if you're applying to master's or doctoral programs on our Boston campus, those typically would not have scholarships available to them. But any student applying to an undergraduate program across all of our programs, scholarships are available for those. So speaking of, you know, now that we know that, you know, pretty much most of our programs do have the ability to get scholarships, what's that process like? You know, do students need to apply, and how do they go about qualifying for scholarships?
Well, that's the good news, actually. There's no application process for scholarships. Every student that applies to MCPHS is automatically reviewed for scholarship. So students, you will receive the decision letter at the same time that you will receive a scholarship award letter, if you have one. Now, if you have any additional documents that you wish to share after your admission, which you think might impact the scholarship decision, you're welcome to send it in. If you have very specific questions that pertain to your individual situation, please go ahead and use the chat box function here on this in this session, and we'll get to your questions. So I guess your question might be, well, so how do I qualify for a scholarship? Greg, can you help us with that?
Yeah, definitely. So it's not as complicated as a process as it might seem. You know, when we're looking as admissions reviewers at your application to determine how much scholarship you're going to be eligible for, we're looking at a few different things. I will say everything really does start with your grades, and particularly your overall GPA, your grade point average. For me as an admissions reviewer, specifically at MCPHS, my eyes immediately kind of gravitate towards your grades in math, biology, and chemistry, which I think makes sense, right? Because those are really the main subject areas that you're going to utilize at MCPHS. That being said, we are going to look at your entire overall GPA as well. Beyond your grades, we're going to look at the other aspects that you've submitted along with your application, which will include things like letters of recommendation from your teachers. If you have submitted any sort of external examinations, like an English proficiency exam, like a TOEFL or an IELTS, or an optional test like an SAT or an ACT, we will take a look at those types of things as well. But something else that also really factors into the process that I think probably a lot of students don't realize is student motivation. And there's a few different ways that we can really kind of assess that motivation factor. Certainly on your application, there are things we can look at, like your personal statement or essay, you know, where we're going to ask you to tell us a little bit about not only why you have chosen to apply to MCPHS, but why the particular major that you're interested in enrolling in. We can also take a look at some of the extracurricular or outside of school activities that you have participated in. And even though these aren't requirements for your application, they can, you know, have an impact on your scholarship. So if you've had an opportunity to join your school science club, or if you've had an opportunity to shadow a doctor or a nurse at a local clinic or hospital, those type of things can certainly look very good on your application and can improve your overall scholarship outcome. You know, ultimately, you know, me as an admission counselor, you know, it's my job to make the recommendation on how much scholarship that you are eligible for receiving. And so knowing how motivated you are and, you know, through not only things like your application, but also through engagements with me or other members of our admission staff, whether it's attending these type of virtual sessions like our open house, whether it's scheduling one-on-one individual advising appointments, or whether it's communicating by email, or whether it's communicating with some of our current international students or alumni. All of these type of things really demonstrate a commitment and a motivation on your part. And I'm able to use that as an admissions reviewer in submitting my scholarship recommendation to ETA, who ultimately would then kind of help to make that final scholarship determination. So anything that you would add there, Ita, from your perspective as somebody who is reading those reviews?
Well, I actually think this is an important point that we want to mention to the students, that we want to highlight, is that the relationship that you build with your admissions counselor will make a difference. The admissions counselor is going to be making that recommendation, not only for admission, but also for scholarships. And he or she is the one who really needs to feel that you are doing everything possible to be a success at MCPHS. So make sure that you're reaching out, engaging, and staying in communication with your admissions counselor. It'll make a difference. Now, we've talked about renewable. So let's get into that just a little bit. Maybe what we want to know is what will make that difference if we can renew our scholarship every year? So we would like to tell you that there is a minimum GPA that you need to have in order to get the scholarship renewed. That GPA is 2.5. And here, that's really everything that matters, is will you have the GPA necessary? Will you maintain the cumulative GPA necessary to keep your scholarship the next year? But if you do, then you have the same amount every year. For example, if you're admitted into our 6-year direct entry doctor of pharmacy program, in this program, if you maintain a 2.5 GPA and you have received a renewable scholarship of $10,000, every year you will get $10,000. Your total scholarship is $60,000. Now, careful. That doesn't mean that 2.5 is enough for you to pass on to every year and progress, but it is enough for you to keep your scholarship. And this is important because I have students who come to me very often and say, wow, look at this big scholarship that I received from this school. I say, well, let's look at the small print. Does that scholarship come back to you every year? Make sure to calculate the total amount of the scholarship for the duration of your studies. Now, Greg, you were talking about making a recommendation. One question that students often ask is, when you make that recommendation, do you take into consideration a student or a family's financial situation?
Yeah, so we definitely understand that a financial situation of a family, their budget is going to play a factor in their decision, you know, to attend a university. For the scholarship determination, however, that is solely based off of academic merit. So we do not factor in ability to pay or any sort of financial factors into the determination for awarding scholarships. But if you do have questions about other ways to finance your education beyond simply the merit-based scholarships, I would certainly encourage you, if you have not already, to check out one of the previous sessions, and you can check out the recording, which was the financing your education session. And that goes into a lot more detail about different methods and options available to you in order to finance your education beyond simply the merit-based scholarships.
It looks like we have questions coming in the chat box. So maybe I see we have a little bit of time. Maybe we can answer a few directly. I see one of the questions, Greg, is what is the average amount given to international students? So we said scholarships range between 2,000 and 16,000. But what's the average that's given out?
Yeah, it'll definitely vary in that range. But in my experience, you know, having worked here for a while, I would say typically most international students are receiving anywhere between $8,000 and $10,000 a year is pretty common. But, you know, the higher your grades and overall aspects of your application, you know, that could go all the way up to 16,000, like we talked about earlier. But $8,000 to $10,000 is a pretty good average number, I would say, that most students are getting.
Let's look at another question. How many international students actually get scholarships? I can take that one. Well, overall, throughout the school, about 60% of international students get a scholarship. But when we look at freshmen, first-year students get, about 90% of first-year students get a scholarship. Now, are there any other scholarships outside of MCPHS, Greg, that students can apply for?
Yeah, there are. You know, it's going to vary, I think, a lot based off of the country that you're in, the country that you're a citizen of. But there are, you know, certain countries will have governmental scholarships. So, you know, you may want to check with your home country to see if they do offer any sort of governmental scholarships. There are also third-party or private study abroad scholarships that some sort of either non-governmental organizations or private companies may offer in order for you to study in a particular area, for example, maybe pharmacy or nursing or something like that, that they may be looking to help fund. So, definitely check with the resources in your home country, check online. There may be things available to you, and it may not necessarily just be, you know, the country that you're a citizen of, the country that you're living in. If that's different from the country that you're a citizen of, they may offer scholarships as well. So, you know, do make sure to check both. And, you know, as always, I think, you know, probably, you know, Google is your friend as well. So, you know, you can certainly check for any sort of outside scholarship opportunities there. And finally, I think the last thing I would probably say is, once again, you know, do check back into that financing your education session that we had earlier in the open house. And there may be some tips in there for you as well.
So go ahead, continue sending in your questions through the chat box, through the button on the right side, on lower right side of your screen. We're going to continue answering them in the chat. And when you're done, don't forget that coming right up after this session, there is a student and alumni panel. You can reach that student and alumni panel with the button that's on the upper left corner of your screen. It'll take you back to the landing page, and you can see all the next upcoming events. And there will be international student on the student and alumni panel, so you don't want to miss it. Thanks so much. We'll meet you in the chat box.
Thank you.